Good morning. Thank you so much for joining me today for a live reading of Jessie's Indigestible Incident. So today is July 3rd. So I just wanted to talk really briefly about the 4th of July and kind of let you know some things. I don't know if you have experience with this or not, but some dogs do not do well on the 4th of July. And sometimes people don't really think about that with all the fireworks that they're letting off and all the loud noises. Jessie has a lot of friends on Instagram and on Facebook, a lot of doggy friends who are having a really rough time right now. Apparently there's been a whole lot of illegal fireworks happening, even for like the past week. So I think it's kind of in every city, it's everywhere. People are just lighting off lots of illegal fireworks. So unfortunately for the dogs and also for some people, some military veterans have a hard time with loud noises as well. So just a reminder to just make sure that you're careful and that you lock your dogs up in the house. Don't let your dogs outside, please, on the 4th of July. The most, like, the shelters are literally flooded with dogs that come in because they're spooked, they get scared of the noise, they run away and can't find their way home or don't come home for whatever reason. Shelters are packed on the 4th of July and for the whole week, probably afterwards, for people trying to find their dogs and getting their dogs back. So there's lots of campaigns going on for microchipping and definitely wearing a collar with information on it. Sometimes if you don't have a tag, you can even with a Sharpie pen write on, you know, a phone number or anything, you know, a phone number on a collar, if nothing else. And just be really careful. Our gate accidentally was left open. And now we use not a lock, but one of those hooks that people put their keys on, those really thick hooks. I know there's a name for them. I can't think of it right now. But we put that on the inside of our gate just to make sure that that doesn't accidentally get left open. So we only open it, obviously taking the trash out and back in, but after that, we always lock the gate to be sure it doesn't accidentally get open. So just be really, really extra careful. And I know from Jessie's perspective, dogs like her appreciate it when we stay home and don't go out on a night like that. New Year's Eve is another bad night for her because she gets really scared. Sometimes she ends up shaking. Or she'll go in the closet. Tucker, he's a little bit different. He'll bark when he hears loud noises. So he barks, she shakes, she runs and hides. It's not a fun day for pets. So just be really, really careful. Okay, now I'll read. Jessie's Indigestible Incident. Well, hello. Remember me? I'm sure you do. I'm that gorgeous celebrity that everyone, who's anyone, is talking about. That's right. I'm Jessie. No? I'm the one with the lopsided ears, one up and one down, and a cute beauty mark on my nose and chest. Still no? I have my own special style when I walk. It's almost like dancing. A little bit of walking, a little bit of wagging my beautiful tail. Let's call it waggling. Just another of my unique talents. Still don't remember? Where have you been? I know. I'm the one with the funny whiskers, one side black, the other white. I knew you'd remember me. How could you not remember the gorgeous pit bull with the pink feather boa? There is no other, just little old exceptional me.
on with my story.
Ever since my mom found me at the shelter, I've had this little issue where I gobble my food. I don't know why, but nobody, and I mean nobody, is going to eat my food. Probably comes from having to eat whatever I could find when I lived on the streets. Well, on this particular day, I refused to eat anything. My mom knew something was wrong because, well, me not eating. So she took me to the veterinarian. Let's just call him the vet. Much easier. Now, I don't like to go to the vet's office. Don't get me wrong, he's nice and all. I just don't like that he has to pay attention to the other dogs. I mean, I'm Jessie. Why does he have to be nice to the others? I'm Jessie. Enough said. She's thinking, pet me, Jessie. When we got there, I tried to give my usual hello by wagging my tail, but I couldn't get my wag up to speed. It just sort of flopped from side to side. He offered me a nice little treat, but I refused to have anything to do with it. Again, not something I would normally do. I love treats. They walked me from the exam room to the back of the hospital where they had this machine that could look at my insides. They called it an X-ray. It could tell if something was wrong in there, but he said nothing looked strange. If you ask me, looking at someone's insides is strange all by itself. They sent us home. I still didn't feel like eating. Mom tried beef and rice. Nope. She tried feeding me boiled chicken. Nope. She even tried Alaskan cod, my mostest very favorite food in the whole world. Still nope. So, the very next day, it was back to the emergency pet hospital. It was horrible. Mom cried because she was so worried. I was getting weak. I didn't even want to drink water. This is where it gets a little embarrassing. Mom had to carry me because I could hardly stand up. The emergency vet wanted to do something called a surgery. He thought I had something in my insides that caused an infection. Now, I don't know what a surgery is, and I don't know what an infection is. All I knew was that I didn't feel good. I wanted to go home. When they admitted me to the hospital, they wrote American Pit Bull Terrier on my paperwork. Not this again. We're just like any other dog. Most of us are just happy to have someone to love. One of the techs had a pit bull at home. She was extra nice. She called me a velvet hippo. She said it was a nickname for pit bulls because our hair is so soft and shiny, like velvet. Also, our big heads and short, squatty bodies make us kind of look like a hippopotamus. I like hippos, even though I never saw one. A real one, anyway. I don't see the resemblance. At least not with me. Anyway, I was hungry, but food just didn't sound good. I started thinking about what I had done in the last few days. There was that business card that I ate and that tissue I scarfed from the trash can. Those were no problem. I had eaten plenty of them before. A couple of days earlier, I was sniffing around the house, smelling all the smells like I normally do, found this extra stinky sock in the clothes hamper. Now, I love to chew on soft things. That's why all the blankets in our house have holes in them. This sock was one of Mom's. I could smell her and it was extra soft. I picked it up with my mouth and out the door I ran. Sometimes Mom sees me with socks and just as I start to get them down my throat, she pulls them out. I know it's a bad habit, but I can't be entirely perfect, can I? This time I got away with it. I swallowed the sock whole. That must be what's making me sick. That nice little extra stinky sock was stuck inside me. I got to thinking about other things I had eaten. There was that $20 bill on the table. That came out. And that stinky glove in the garden. I chewed the fingers and thumb off. They all came out. I even ate a part of the TV remote. That came out too. Somehow they had all come out. Why was the sock making me feel so sick? The next thing I remember was the text petting and talking to me. They were so nice. I must have fallen asleep. When I woke up, I felt different. I had tubes attached to my paws and all my beautiful hair was gone from my belly. And I had small silver lines all over my tummy. They kind of looked like jewelry. Is that what I look like under my hair? What happened while I was asleep? Surgery? Anyway, I was very tired and I still didn't want to eat. They offered me boiled chicken. Nope. They offered me beef and rice. Nope. They didn't have any Alaskan cod, so they offered me canned cat food. Now that is so stinky, I usually can't resist, but not this time. Everything they offered me looked like socks. Socks in a bowl? Yummy! Not! Chicken was white socks, the beef and rice were striped socks, and the cat food was brown socks. Yuck! I was not going to eat a bowl of socks. Ew! The tech took me out of my cage and we slowly and carefully walked down the hall to a small room. I had to be careful because I still had that tube taped to my paw and all that jewelry on my tummy was not comfortable at all. Once we got into the room, guess what? My mom was there. I was so happy to see her. I couldn't jump up, so I just wagged my tail as best I could. I held my gorgeous ears back so she could pat my face. She put a bowl of something on the floor and sat right there next to me. She was petting me and talking to me, and guess what? In the bowl was my favorite. You guessed it, Alaskan cod. My mom brought Alaskan cod to the emergency hospital for me. I forgot all about the bowls of socks they tried to feed me. Suddenly, I felt better. I ate everything in the bowl while Mom was talking away. It was really nice to hear her voice. Aw, she sure loves you, the tech said. I thought, yes, yes I do. Even more,
than I love Alaskan cod.
I walked out of there with a little extra wiggle in my waggle, probably because of all that jewelry. When we got home, I noticed we had a new clothes hamper, one where the lid snapped shut. Thank goodness. Well, I guess that's the end of my sock tale. Next time, I'll tell you about another one of my adventures. Actually, that next adventure is really close to happening. Some special things happening right now. I will be putting up in the next, I don't know, probably a week or so, pre-sales for the new book on my website. I also have sets available now. So a set of two hardbacks or a set of the first two books in paperback. At a cheaper rate, they're marked down a lot. In fact, every single book is on sale. Even if you got one book, hardcover or paperback, they're all marked down. So go to my website, take a look, www.jessiethepitmix.com. So I'll put a link in the comments if you're watching this on Facebook Live. And otherwise, if you're on YouTube watching it, give me a like and subscribe to the channel. Again, the website, www.jessiethepitmix.com. Enjoy your 4th of July. Take good care of your pups. Bye. Thank you for watching. Bye.